Ah, fidget spinners. I remember that fad like it was just yesterday. For the longest time, no one had one. Then all of a sudden, so many people had them. There were kids who were willing to pay ridiculous amounts of money just to make sure they had a fidget spinner. Demand for these gadgets came out of nowhere. Hey there. In today's lesson, we are going to take a deeper look into demand in a market economy. By the end of the lesson, you should be able to answer the following. What are two things that can change demand in a market? What factors shift demand in a market? How do changes in demand impact the demand curve? And you should start thinking about our big picture question. Why does studying demand help us better understand consumers' behavior in a market? So in yesterday's lesson, we defined demand as the desire for a good or service combined with the ability to pay for it, and determined that it described markets from a consumer's perspective. Because a consumer's perspective impacts demand, it means that demand has an inverse relationship with price. The less expensive a good or service is, the greater the demand for that good or service. Ah, the good old law of demand. We also said that demand in a market represents a snapshot in time. So that means that there can be changes to demand. One of these changes is caused by a change in the price of a good or service. When pizza costs $15, you might only want to buy one. But if the price changes to $10, you could be talked into buying two pizzas. This change in price led to a change in quantity demanded. But sometimes there are things unrelated to price that change demand, at every price. These non-price events are called shifters of demand. Okay, let's take a minute to check in. How can you explain the differences between a change in quantity demanded and shifters of demand? Now, while changes in price cause changes in the quantity demanded, there are certain non-price factors that cause shifts in demand. We're going to take a few minutes to discuss these non-price factors. If you open up your PDF, you'll find a graphic organizer to help you take notes about these non-price factors. Income refers to the money or compensation that an individual or household earns over a specified period. Changes in an individual's income can change their demand for a good or service. Let's say you want to buy a new video game console, but right now you aren't able to pay for it. But what if your job paid you a sizable holiday bonus? That bonus, an increase in income, might allow you to purchase the gaming console, shifting your demand. Consumer preference refers to attitudes or opinions that consumers have about different goods or services. Think about our example from earlier, fidget spinners. Before that fad began, do you think people even thought about buying a fidget spinner? But once they saw other people buying and using it, all of a sudden, everybody had to have one. Demand for it skyrocketed. Consumers' preferences had changed, even for a little while. Demographic characteristics are measurable characteristics of a population, including age, gender, education level, family size, and so on. After World War II, American soldiers returned home and began starting families, leading to a population increase that historians refer to as a baby boom. During the 1950s and 60s, American companies designed and produced new toys, clothes, and even cars designed to appeal to these boomers. Expectations of future price refers to consumer beliefs about whether prices for a good or service will be higher or lower in the future. Maybe it's getting close to the end of October and you really need a new television. You might buy that TV right now, but there's a good chance that you're going to wait a month because November and the holiday season usually means great sales and friendly prices on electronics. The price of related goods refers to the impact of the price of one good on the demand for a good that typically accompanies it. You know, pancakes and syrup, peanut butter and jelly. Think about walking into the grocery store and seeing ice cream on sale, so you decide to buy some. Well, you might also buy cones to go with the ice cream, even though you weren't planning on it when you left your house. All right, take a few minutes to think of some examples of each of these non-price shifters of demand to complete your graphic organizer. Now that we've identified some of the shifters of demand, let's take a few minutes to talk about how we represent them in graph form. Let's take a look at our basic demand curve. If it's a price change, this is going to cause a change in the quantity demanded, and that is represented by movement along the current demand curve. But in the case of those non-price shifters of demand, where demand is changed at every price, we need a whole new demand curve. When we analyze those shifters of demand, we have to decide whether it's going to cause an increase or decrease in demand. In the case of increasing demand, we say that the demand curve has shifted to the right. But if demand is decreasing, we say that the demand curve has shifted to the left. Imagine that you and your best friend normally get a pizza, watch movies, and play video games on some Friday nights. This is your base demand curve for pizza. Well, let's say that one Friday night your friend is sick and it's just you. Well, due to a demographics change, the demand for pizza has decreased at every price point, and the demand curve has shifted to the left. But what if one Friday night you get together with three more friends, bringing the total number of people to 5? What happens to the demand for pizza in that scenario? That's right, demand increases, and the entire demand curve shifts to the right. Okay. Take a moment to practice this for yourself. Car manufacturers often lower the price of this year's models after next year's models hit the market. This year, one company announced that next year's models will be available for sale in October. What do you think will most likely happen to demand for this year's models in September? What happens to the demand curve? What shifter of demand is causing this? All right, let's take a few minutes to recap what we've learned today. There are two ways that demand can be impacted in the market: changes in prices and non-price factors. These non-price shifters of demand include changes in income, changes in customer preferences, demographic changes, expectations of future prices, and changes in prices of related goods or services. When demand is impacted by changes in price, this creates a change in quantity demanded and is represented by movement along the demand curve. Non-price shifters of demand create changes in demand at all prices and result in a new demand curve that shifts either to the left or right. Tomorrow, we're going to examine the supply side of things. And remember, keep investing in yourself one lesson at a time. See you next time. Hey, hey.